Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, as your children, we have so much for which to be thankful. But gratitude is a discipline before it's a feeling, a remembering before it's a rejoicing. Indeed, gratitude is warfare, a bold and strong defense against envy, whining, and fear. So as this Thursday begins, we want to express thanks for the two wonderful four words of gift of the gospel. No matter what else is going on in our hearts, day, and world, we are hidden in Christ, beloved as his children, sealed and dwelt with your spirit, standing in grace, rooted in love. We'll never experience separation from your affection, disruption of Jesus' constant intercession, interruptions to your sovereign determinations. Why would we ever fear or complain about anything? But there's still more to fuel our gratitude. Father, thank you that one day you'll put everything right, making all things new and wipe every tear. Thank you that you are presently working in all things for our good and for your glory, even in the things that vex us, confuse us, and disrupt us. Here's to staying grateful. So very amen, we pray in Jesus' tender and triumphant name. Okay, we are going to have a wonderful concert. I'm excited to hear the boys and girls.
Mm-hmm.
appreciate it so much. So thank you so much. The next song that we're going to sing was first introduced to me at the Kansas Music Educators Association District Honor Choir. And we brought, back in the days when we could have honor choir, we brought some of our students to participate in that event. And when I first saw this piece of music, I thought, this is all in unison. And these are the very, very best fourth and fifth, and sometimes sixth graders, from the whole side of the state. And we're doing a unison song, and that kind of surprised me a little. It's a piece that is based on an Irish poem, and it is arranged by Benjamin Britten, who is a premier composer and arranger for choral music. It is beautiful. And at first, I will give the kids credit, because it is a poem, and the first appearance seems to be about love, because it talks about loving things. And if any of you have any of the fourth graders up here, you know that is kind of a verboten sort of a subject to don't talk about love in fourth grade. But it really isn't about love. It's talking about life and living a life without regrets and being able at the end of your life to look back and be glad for the choices you've made. So I hope as you listen to the words and this lovely love. Serious is about a past. So I hope you enjoy Down the Flips Away.
Thank you. able to nurture and love here. The words are so beautiful. I pray you'll be our guide and watch us where we go. Help us to be wise in times that we don't know. It's just a prayer that every parent sends to their, or for their children. It's also something I pray for myself, even as an elder person. I still pray for that guidance and that all the things that come with faith and that enrich our lives. So we are sending our fifth graders off to middle school, and this is my prayer for them as they say for you.
Thank you.
integrated curriculum. So we are going to perform for you three pieces. The words are by the highly esteemed Benjamin Franklin, and they have been arranged for children's choir. This is pure fun. Thank you. Mr. Preston and Mrs. Stark, who I think have just without what they added to our program was just tremendous. What an opportunity for kids at 10 and 11 years old to play with professional musicians and to have that opportunity. So we so appreciate that. Mrs. Swearingen is our art and Spanish teacher, and she has a curriculum just like I do. And she has allowed me, when needed, to borrow the children for a little bit of extra practice. And that kind of flexibility is the only place in the world that I know of that that happens is this building. I cannot imagine being able to have the kind of staff that I work with here at any other school. It is just tremendous, but especially Mrs. Swearingen is flexibility in every way. Without that, we wouldn't be able to pull off this. So thank you to her. All the teachers, I've said for I think 11 years now, this is a staff unlike any other that I've ever taught at any other school. And at this stage in my life, I've taught at Fairmont schools, public schools, one other Christian school. This is a really special place, and it's the teachers, administrators that make it that way. So thank you to all of them. Thank you, Mr. Wheeler, who, in addition to keeping a very large and active group of sixth graders on task at all times, is running our sound today. Mr. Arcadius is doing our taping, and we appreciate that so much. I hope all of you parents, even if you have the slightest complaints about this school year, because you are here, I hope that on a daily basis you thank God for our administration, for Mr. Sunny, for Mrs. Siebert, for all the things that they did last summer that allowed us to have this school year, and for all the things that they have done and had to change as the school year changed. And the CBC, C does not stand for consistent. And they have had to change so many things over and over. And I have just watched them look down with grace. And I am so thankful to the administration that got us back to school and allowed all of these things to happen. I was really nervous in the fall, but I thought it was going to die. But, you know, it has been just God's blessing on us all year long. We've just seen it, and it has been so wonderful. So thank you to them for their wise leadership. Thank you to Mrs. things that are non-academic. And so when I saw this song the first time, it just made me laugh because it's like, well, that's exactly how we feel all spring. So I hope you enjoy a rather boisterous version of Bang the Drum.
One, two, one, two.